Hello, friends. For years now, a fragment from the German show Welt der Wunder, World of Wonders, has been circulating on the internet, in which enthusiasts directly compare katanas manufactured using medieval technology with a one-and-a-half-handed sword. During the strength test through direct collision, the katana unequivocally capitulates, which sparked a lively discussion. Perhaps there is no other weapon surrounded by as many myths as the katana. It is widely known that the almost magical properties of the Japanese sword are associated with a unique technology of alternating layers of ductile and hard metal. However, tactfully omitted is the fact that this technology was already known in Europe as early as the 3rd century BC. It is also worth noting that any high-quality steel, starting from the early Iron Age, was manufactured using the refining method, combining multiple layers of metal. One of the arguments in favor of the katana is that ancient Japanese masters combined thousands of layers, achieving perfection and extraordinary blade properties. However, in practice, the number of layers used is limited. After reaching the maximum, the blade simply loses all the advantages provided by this technology. The multi-layer approach was likely a result of the less than ideal iron sources in Japan, which consisted of iron sand with various impurities. Effective purification technologies for iron sand only emerged in the 20th century. Strangely enough, katanas made from modern high-quality steel have better characteristics than medieval specimens. When comparing the katana with its European counterpart, the one-and-a-half-handed sword, it is important to note the slightly different properties of these weapons. The sword is primarily a cutting-stabbing weapon, while the katana serves as an auxiliary cutting-stabbing weapon. Surprisingly, the primary weapon of the samurai was the bow. This brings us to an important point that automatically debunks many myths about the katana. Blades with approximately equal hardness on the Rockwell scale cannot physically cut each other. Regardless of the number of layers or the sharpness of the katana, it cannot cut steel of similar thickness. On the other hand, the superiority of the European sword in direct collision with the katana lies in its greater blade thickness and mass. The one-and-a-half-handed sword weighed approximately 300 grams more than the katana. All these factors contribute to the result we can observe in the video. 49.